The Trump administration is considering a plan to ask Americans to wear facial masks to help slow the spread of coronavirus, especially in hard-hit areas. The news comes after another record day of new cases. Correspondent Owen Jensen reports now in the White House. Owen.
Here at the White House, Tracy, they're talking new facial covering guidelines. Across the globe, more than a million people have been infected by the coronavirus. Nearly 60,000 have died.
Businesses closed, people home, social distancing. Still, the insidious coronavirus finding its victims. This New York City nurse knows the virus firsthand.
One of the first things you realize is that everyone who has this, it comes differently for everyone. Like when I had it, I didn't really have a cough. My lung sounds were clear pretty much the whole time, but I had a fever. Like I just had a constant fever.
While many are wearing masks, not everyone is. And now new guidelines with people being told to wear some kind of facial covering if they're going to be around others.
If people wanted to wear them, they can. If people wanted to use scarves, which they have, many people have them, they can. In many cases, the scarf is better. It's thicker.
If you're headed to the grocery store or pharmacy, places actually still open, a non-medical mask, t-shirts, or bandanas could be used to cover the nose and mouth.
And we don't want people to get an artificial sense of protection because they're behind a mask.
But of course, nothing is foolproof.
Because if they're touching things, remember, your eyes are not in the mask. So if you're touching things and then touching your eyes, you're exposing yourself in the same way.
Meanwhile, more devastating economic numbers. Airport security checkpoints screened fewer than 125,000 people Thursday. The same day last year saw 2.5 million people pass through. Also, half of the people in the world are reportedly on lockdown orders. And while so many are out of work, the Army Corps of Engineers is working overtime to help cities create pop-up hospitals.
We don't have the ability and the time to be able to do it like everybody would like. I'm telling our guys, you got X amount of days, you get the mission essential piece done by the time that mayor needs it done.
Now, those N95 masks, also known as respirators, well, healthcare professionals really need those. They're in short supply, and the company 3M says they'll be making more of those for the United States. Tracy?
Okay, thank you. Owen, correspondent Owen Jensen reporting from the White House.